by the variety of blue types.
Sea scars, great clubs,
no fresh catch.
What? What?
Damn it.
A black
get in.
Connor, hello again. What brings you to Boston?
You.
Would you excuse us, fellows? Thank you. That conversation was about to turn unpleasant. Now, what can I do for you?
I was hoping you could help me locate William Johnson.
Of course. I'm headed to a meeting with some men who should be able to help. Why don't you come along? Ah, it's good to see the people finally taking a stand against... justice?
Says the man who owns a slave.
Ooh, sorry? I practice what I preach, my friend. She's not a slave, but a freed woman. At least on paper. Men's minds are not so easily turned. It's a tragedy that for all our progress, still we cling to such barbarism.
Then speak out against it.
We must focus first on defending our rights. When this is done, we'll have the luxury of addressing these other matters.
You speak as though your condition is equal to that of the slaves. It is not.
Tell that to my neighbor who is
my home, no matter what you thieves called taxmen say. If the gumps in Parliament who want to take my property, you tell them to sail across the pond and take it themselves.
It's not open for discussion now. Open this door or these men will break it down.
Ah, bollocks, we're coming in.
Trust the mounting evidence is proof enough, Connor.
Continue on. I shall meet you at our destination.
Justice for once. I dare the governor to send more.
You all right?
I'm fine. It's not my first dance. For all their teeth and claws, these little foxes, they fight like puppies. Thank you, my friend. I'd buy you an ale, but I'm expected somewhere else.
We must not do it!
You'll have to do much better.
Ooh.
Remember that it is your friends, neighbors, and relations that are being killed. Most humorous. Droll, even. on, Anvil offers you the finest fare in the city.
Connor, I'd like you to meet some like-minded friends. The owner of this fine establishment, William Molyneux, and the manager and chef of his newest venture, Stéphane Chaffaut.
Ah, Connor and I just had a ball with some red coats enforcing some taxmen outside my home.
The collectors grow bolder and more forceful. Something we must address, Samuel.
Then let us raise a banner. Something to let the people know that they are not alone. The docks are an angry place of late. Protesters picketing the latest shipments of British tea. The eyes of the city are upon that stage.
A Bostonian without his tea is a dangerous beast.
William Johnson is smuggling the tea off the ships. One of his men tried to sell me this. A sample of what I refused. But it's from those ships. No mistaking the stamp. He's charging a king's ransom. Must be he's making a mint off those who buy it.
Where is he now?
I've never met the man.
May I ask why you seek him, Connor?
He intends to purchase the land upon which my village stands, without the consent of my people.
No doubt the revenue from his little smuggling endeavor is financing the acquisition. A tax enforced on tea grants a boon to smugglers. I'll wager the same men who levy the taxes are selling the tea. A stage requires a spectacle, and I may know the play. Connor, head back to the docks and see to the destruction of the tea. If you should need us, return here. Go on, Connor.
Hello, Connor. That tea is being illegally smuggled all around Boston by Johnson's men. If you see any crates in transit, perhaps you could put a stop to the delivery. Hello, Connor. That tea is being illegally smuggled all around Boston by Johnson's men.
Pardon me.
Oh, come on, mate.
Ship him to Bedlam. got a shot!
I'll make short work of you!
You come back here! Stop you!
You come back here, you!
Got to get away from here. Double time.
I am no threat.
Captain Raffier will not desist.
There's something one doesn't see every day.
Stefan, what is wrong? Where is Sam Adams?
Who cares? I've been robbed!
Vont me payer, ces scélérats de merde!
Where are you going?
To get back what's rightfully mine.
Redcoats waiting for a beating! I will match your face to your jacket, Captain!
Ces coquins me prennent mon père au Canada et voilà qui me ravise ma propriété ici! Il suffit!
Stefan, please! Stop and listen to me!
I've listened for long enough. They come into my home and take my things? I will get my revenge. The man responsible for this will pay. His friends will pay. Voilà trop longtemps que je subis ces affronts. Ils vont goûter de mon courroux. You looking for a fight, Englishman? I'll give you what you want.
Oh,
justice, but this is not it.
Destroyed? You stupid mackerel! I suppose you want me to tell Johnson his tea just spontaneously combusted? Nonsense! Someone's responsible for this, and you will find out who. And if you can't, I'll gut you and find a smarter mongrel who can.
What do we do? Create a window.
Bloody hell are you?
Why? You have no right to rob people blind. By decree of the British Parliament or not.
British Parliament? I work for William Johnson.
Johnson?
End his suffering cleanly.
Please.
What are the things you lost?
The people listened to me only because I spoke the truth loud enough, which is worth 1,000 times the content of my footlocker. The English, they can keep my teams.
You did well tonight.
I said I'd buy you an ale when you first helped me. In place of drink, I offer you my allegiance, for what it's worth.
Your aid is welcome, and I am grateful. Now, I need to find Sam Adams.
Thank you.
Governor Hutchison refuses to let them leave.
What happens now?
We wait for the signal.
What signal?
This meeting can do nothing further to save the country.
That one.
Evening, gentlemen. Shall we be off?
No.
What's the matter?
I have spent a day drawn from one bit of madness to another with nothing to show for it. Before I go any further, I would like to know exactly what it is you intend.
Of course. First, we make our way to Nathaniel Bradley's house to fetch the rest of our little group. Then it's on to Griffin's Wharf, where we board the ships and dump the tea. Simple as that.
Simple seems a bit charitable.
Cheer up, Connor. For tonight, we are all victors. The Sons of Liberty get to send a message to England, and you rob William Johnson of his financing. Your village will be saved.
I've an idea. Why don't you lead the way? That should keep us out of any further trouble. Am I right?
Damn it, more guards.
We need to turn the crowd's anger to our advantage.
Say the word, Connor, and I will make it so. We need to keep those bastards at bay while the tea's being dumped.
Let me help. I'm yours to command.
Thank you.
We've done it!
Connor! We saved the last one for you. Best we get out of here, huh?
It is done.
Johnson is dead?
No. He retreated when we destroyed the team.
Only to hatch some new scheme, I'm sure. You should have killed him.
There was no need.
Time will tell if you speak the truth.